Hey everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to the Rideshare Hub. My name is Dylan and thank you so much for coming by. The Rideshare Hub is a place for Uber and Lyft drivers to learn how to make more money and be better rideshare drivers. So just to introduce myself, my name is Dylan. I am a driver for Uber and Lyft. I signed up about 2 years ago now. And in today's video, I'm basically gonna be going over a Q&A. I wanna start doing these weekly where I basically just answer some of your questions that you have for me. So before I get into this video, if you have any more questions that you want me to answer on next week's Q&A video, leave them down in the comment section down below, and then next week I'll go through this comment section. Any questions you have related to rideshare driving or about myself, I'll be happy to answer them if you're lucky. So without further ado, let's hop right into it. Give the video a big thumbs up, I would really appreciate it, and also make sure to subscribe so you are notified whenever I post a video. So without further ado, let's hop right into it. Let's go right through these. Let's go quick, as fast as we can. Let's hop right into it. All right, so the first question from Anthony Stone. Question, what can I do if a passenger takes a while at a stop or if I know they're going to take a while before their stop? So if you have a passenger who wants to take a stop midway through the trip, there's a couple of ways of going about this. If a passenger ever asks me, hey, do you mind if I stop at the liquor store really quick? I just need to grab a drink. Usually I'll say, yeah, sure, no big deal. If it's a shared ride, however, I have to say, sorry, you know, I need to take the other passenger to the destination. I pretty much say no unless the other passenger's like, yeah, go for it, I don't care. However, I have had one case and I did make this mistake where a passenger wanted to go to Target and she wanted to get a couple groceries, and I was just feeling really nice that day and I said, hey, you know what, don't worry about it, I'll sit outside and wait for you. It took 30 minutes. I was sitting outside for 30 minutes and I couldn't leave because she put her bike in my car. Yeah, I was just going way over the top for this girl. I don't think she left a tip. It was like 40, it ended up being like an hour long ride with this girl for like 17 bucks. But I put the seats down and her bike was in my car and I'm just sitting in my car waiting for her. And yeah, it was like 30 to 35 minutes that she was inside Target. Absolutely crazy. I thought she was just gonna be in and out really quick. And yeah, I even like sat right outside the door waiting for her and I ended up having to go park because it was taking so long. So usually no, but if it's really quick, yeah, it's probably fine. All right, the next question is from Leonard McCaffrey. Cool vid. Does it matter how fast or slow you get your passenger to their location? Not really, to be honest. Like, I mean, drive the speed limit. You don't need to speed to get there. Like, your passengers don't really care. I always say, guys, like, just drive the speed limit. Your passengers don't care if you're gonna get there 30 seconds or a minute late. If you're taking wrong turns all the time, I mean, if you take a wrong turn here and there, it's no big deal. But yeah, just drive the speed limit. I mean, your passenger knows that taking Uber and Lyft is probably gonna be faster than taking the bus or walking. But if there's traffic, there's not really much you can do besides drive. Just drive the speed limit, drive as you normally would with your family member or somebody that you know you wanna keep really safe. You know, obviously don't text and drive, but to answer a question, no, it does not really matter that much as long as you're not missing turns or taking super long to get there. All right, the next question from Duck Nasty. He said, should I sign up to Lyft and Uber or just drive for Uber? This is a great question. It definitely depends on your market and how often you want to drive. If you're just driving part-time, I say honestly, maybe just stick to one platform because it is easier like on the payouts. But if you're driving full-time and you know you want to go out for several hours, doing both apps, I mean, even part-time drivers, it could be good to drive for both apps. For whatever reason, for me, I like to just stick to one platform. I don't know why that is, but well, like at a certain time, I mean, I do drive for both apps, but like if I'm gonna go out, I'm gonna drive just for Uber for a night or just for Lyft for a night. But I know tons of people who drive for both apps at the same exact time. So I honestly recommend getting the sign up guarantee or bonus or whatever you wanna call it. Use the referral code for one app for Uber. Finish all those rides and then hop to Lyft and then figure out which one you like better. I personally kind of do prefer Lyft just because I feel like the passengers are a little bit cooler, a little bit better, because they're like seeking out a better platform and a lot of them don't like Uber and they like, I don't know, I don't know. I feel like people are just friendlier on Lyft. I could be wrong though. But yeah, to answer your question, I honestly say try both and see which one you prefer, or you can do both, you know. It's a, you know, no risk. All right, so the next one is Mushir Joseph. He says, for Uber purposes, is leasing a vehicle the best choice? I would say yes if you're driving full time and you don't want to put miles on your car. Like if you have a brand new like BMW or even like a brand new any style car, and putting on miles, you're going to depreciate that. I would definitely look into renting. I don't know if it's the best option. But if you're able to drive full time, and you know, because it's going to cost you around $200 a week, you know, for that rental car, I would say rent the car and then just drive. Or if you have zero car, I would definitely recommend leasing a car rather than going out and buying one just for Uber or Lyft. And then again, I have heard the case as well. These are like, it's not a yes or no question. For I have heard of people who just drive part-time, like 1-2 days a week, just to pay for the car, just so they can use it for their personal selves, which I thought honestly was like, dang, that's like hacking. You're just driving Uber like or Lyft like 1 day a week just to pay for the car, and then the rest of the week you just have it for yourself. So that way you don't need to buy a car or have a car payment. Well, your car payment is the lease payment. Next question is from Joshua Leader. Can I say no to eating, smoking, or swearing in my vehicle? Yes, you can. As an independent contractor, you pretty much set most of the rules. If a passenger gets in and says, hey, I want to eat the spaghetti in my car, and you said, sorry, I don't, you know, this is my car, and I don't want, it's going to spill at my car, it's going to spill. I mean, try to be nice about it. Most people are just being, you know, if they're actually asking, they're gonna be considered. If they just get in and start munching on potato chips and spilling all over your seat, honestly, probably just hit them with the cleaning fee. It's not worth the argument. Just take a picture of it and send it in. In terms of smoking, heck no. I'm not letting anybody smoke in my car. Vaping, that's another story. That stuff is just like water vapor and it like airs out. But I've even heard that the chemicals in Juuls are pretty bad now, so I don't even know. It's up to you, make your own decision. And swearing, yeah, again, you know, you might want to say, I mean, swearing, you can't really say too much about it, but you can, if somebody's like cussing, you might like, I don't know, you might say, hey, do you mind, you know, I don't know, I would appreciate if you could like talk normally, I don't know. you could pretty much say, as long as you're not like discriminating against them, which I don't see how that could be, I say it's probably fine if you, that's just being a normal person. Like, if you're sitting at a bus stop, or if you're in church and somebody's cussing, you might say, like, hey, do you mind if you don't cuss? Because, or, I don't know, maybe not church, but, like, or in a classroom. I don't know. It's up to you, pretty much. All right, the next question is, VipKid, Teacher Eric, how do I add a referral code to my application? I think you're talking about the retroactive one. This just works for Uber. So, if you sign up for Uber and you forgot to use a referral code, you could still try to apply a referral code. It usually just works for newer drivers, but I've seen people driving for like months, even years, it works for them. For Lyft, you have to sign up with the code when you're signing up. Like if you forget to use a code, sorry, you can't do it. I'll leave the instructions in the description for you, VipKid, or for anybody else. All right, the next question is, what is a good app to calculate mileage and gas for tax write-offs? I've heard good things about MileIQ. And then another one is called QuickBooks. I personally just do it all on my own. I know it's only like $5 a month to pay for that, and like you're gonna save thousands of dollars of taxes, but I like to just do it on my own, so I track it all on my own, just on like my notes tabs or my notes app. You can do it on Excel or Microsoft Word as well. But MileIQ and what's it called? QuickBooks is pretty good. Okay, the next one, Timothy A. Cohen. Can people tip me the day after? Yes, you can. So I actually recently had somebody who did tip me the day after. And let me just try to find that ride. Yeah, so this was like the other day. I remember this ride so specifically because it was this one at 11:38 p.m. That ride right here, that was the day after. So I, you know, it like literally I woke up and I saw the extra $3. That was great because you see my last ride of the night, well, towards the end, you know, I got a $12.71 ride, well, my second to last ride. And then the ride before that was almost $11. So those two rides right there was like 25 bucks or I don't know, 22 bucks or something. So yes, they can tip you the day after. Raymond Biebritz, what's the bonus code? It's a referral code. It's not really like a bonus, a cash bonus. It could end up being a cash bonus depending on how much you make, but it's more of like a guarantee now. So if you, I don't know, for example, you go out and do 100 rides, they're going to guarantee you that you make $1,000. So, you know, let's say you go out and do 100 rides, and you only make 600, you're going to get $400 cash. They're going to meet you half, like meet the difference. But those structures are completely different based on your market. I'll leave the codes in the description. El Diablo, do you date women exclusively? Yes. I don't know why that matters, but yes, I do. Adriana Diaro, how many rides do you have to complete in order to receive the retroactive bonus? Again, that does vary based on your market. It could be like 10 rides, it could be 50, it could be 100. So just when you click on the link, make sure you read like what they say, read the fine print and everything. Sandra Mariano says, so Dylan, we can only call the passenger only after we get the day of reminder once we see their name, right? After we get the day of reminder. I think you're talking about the, if you can call your passenger to ask for where their destination is, because that was on that video. Okay, this one, I know, like, this people are up in arms about this, but technically you can call your passenger to ask them about their destination, right? I mean, you can contact your passenger. But if you're canceling because of that, then you kind of run the risk. So I don't know, I got a message from them saying that you can, however, yeah, you don't want to cancel too much because you risk being deactivated. The last question is from a bigger view / seeking truth in God's, I don't know, your name cut off, but you said, how many hours do you drive a week? That varies. It really varies. Up to 30 hours a week, sometimes 0 hours a week. It just literally depends on my schedule. Sometimes 5 hours a week. 10 hours is like my sweet spot. That's like my perfect week. That's like a couple hours a day. If you do you use a dash cam? If you do not, why? But if you do drive, just post a few videos of you picking up passengers and end the rumors. So this is regarding, for whatever reason, there's people out there who have been making videos about me saying that I'm not a driver, pretty much just picking on me at this point. I've made countless videos going over my earnings because, you know, my channel is about earnings or how to increase your earnings. So I naturally talk about my own earnings, and for whatever reason, people think that I use like a fake profile, but regardless, whatever. I think this guy's trying to ask me, oh, hey, Dylan, you know, I think he's actually being like a good sport about it. He's saying, hey, you know what? Why don't you post videos of your rides? And that way people, you know, will have no other choice but to believe you. However, there is an issue with this. As a driver, you are not allowed to post video or audio of your passengers on the internet. There have actually been some cases where drivers have been deactivated for posting videos on the internet. Ryan is driving is a great example. He is a driver, he posts his videos, he makes them really funny, really entertaining, heartfelt, almost artistic, and Uber actually deactivated him because, I think it was because he didn't want to delete the videos and they asked him to delete the videos. There also was another case where a driver got deactivated for live streaming. This is another big thing. You are under no circumstances allowed to live stream your rides as a driver, and this, here's a case right here. Uber driver suspended after live streaming passengers on Twitch. There was a case where basically this guy, he a rideshare driver working for both Uber and Lyft has been suspended after covertly recording and live streaming passengers to Twitch. Streaming passenger pickups is not a new phenomenon. Yeah, basically, Gargot's Twitch channel has since been completely deactivated. The comp- The company told multiple outlets that they do not comment on terms of service violations in regards to specific individuals and do not allow people to share content that invades others' privacy. Regardless of the legal connotations, both Uber and Lyft have now suspended Gargak from operating as a driver. Basically, he was live streaming his passengers' audio on, both audio and video. And here, let me just pull up this screenshot because I actually was curious about this. So I recently just sent Uber support a message and I said, hey, are you allowed to live stream your passengers onto YouTube? Because I've been, thinking about doing it and I have seen other drivers do it. And here's what they said. They said, here to explain, drivers may choose to install and use video cameras, dash cams, or other recording devices to record rides or otherwise for the purpose of fulfilling transportation services. So yes, you can for safety, like just in case, you can have a dash cam for safety purposes. For entertainment purposes, that's a whole nother story. It says local law or regulations may require individuals using recording equipment in vehicles to fully disclose to riders that they are being recorded in or around a vehicle and obtain consent. Please check local regulations in your city to determine if these apply. Now, going back to the article, this is about the Twitch streamer who is live streaming his rides to Twitch. He's in a one-party state that legally he was doing everything fine. He's allowed to record audio and video. But live streaming it, you are not allowed to do even if you are in a one-party state. He is in Missouri and it says, as he operates in Missouri, Gargak's actions are legally sound. The state allows for recording conversations under a one-party consent law. If you are a party in a conversation, as Gargak is in his live stream, you are legally allowed to record it. So, even though it was legal for him to live stream it, Uber and Lyft deactivated him because it is against their terms of service. And, as you can see here, it says, Uber said broadcasting a person's image, audio, or video recording is not allowed. For more information regarding your concern, please visit this link. Let's go to that link really quick. Here is uber.com Uber community guidelines. Sorry, I'm just gonna try to scroll through all of this. Here we go. Use of cameras or other video or audio recording devices. Here it again. Drivers may choose to install and use video cameras, dash cams, or other recording devices to record rides or otherwise for the purpose of fulfilling transportation services. Local law or regulations may require individuals using recording equipment in vehicles to fully disclose to riders that they are being recorded in or around a vehicle and obtain consent. Please check local regulations in your city to determine if these do apply. And then on the term of broadcasting, broadcasting a person's image, audio, or video recording is not allowed. Let's define broadcasting because that even is a pretty loose term. Let's look at definition number 3. To send out or transmit something such as a program by means of radio or television or by streaming over the internet. Again, just so everybody's in the clear, broadcasting a person's image, audio, or video recording is not allowed. So even if your camera is facing towards the street and you can hear your passengers talking, you can and most likely will get deactivated for doing this. It is completely against terms of service. And that is why I do not record my rides. Just so you guys know, I needed to explain this because there's been some confusion and I know a lot of people do record and post their rides. And some people are even live streaming their rides right on YouTube, which is absolutely crazy and totally against terms of service. And totally, they're being risk of being deactivated from both platforms, or whichever one they're using. So there you guys know, you cannot live stream your rides or post any videos of your rides. But if you do, you can, but just know you probably will eventually get deactivated for it. So anyways, guys, that's it for this week's Q&A. Again, leave your comments down below for next week's Q&A. I'll be happy to answer any questions that you might have. If you're lucky, I will choose yours. So thank you again so much for watching today's video. This has been another episode of the Rideshare Hub. Please leave the video a big thumbs up if you did enjoy it. It really helps my videos out so much and helps my videos get pushed out to a wider audience and therefore in return helps me make better videos. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss another video on my channel. All right, have a good day, guys. Peace.